Well, this is your devotional for May 12th, and we're looking at Proverbs chapter 19. Just continue to walk through Proverbs. And in this chapter, I found four different passages that kind of talk about family relationships, how people get along in the family, how they relate in the family. And there's some kind of fun, interesting bits in here. And so I'm just going to walk through a couple passages in Proverbs chapter 19. Verse 13 says this, "A foolish child is a father's ruin, and a quarrelsome wife is like the constant dripping of a leaky roof." You thought I was going to skip that one, didn't you? You thought, okay, Pastor Kevin's going to jump over those kind of passages, but I'm not. I want to talk about this. What it's really saying is how our kids behave. If you're a parent, it affects us. It can ruin our heart. It can ruin our day. If our kids are wandering, boy, we got to pray for kids. We got to love kids. We got to teach them the ways of the Lord the best we can and know that there's heartache when kids wander. And then it talks about a quarrelsome wife is like the constant dripping of a leaky roof. I would call that a quarrelsome person, a husband or a wife, somebody who loves to quarrel. Man, drip, 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 drip. And so if you're a quarreler, if you're always picking a fight with your spouse, I would challenge you to not be like that, to not be that constant dripping. I tell couples that are going to get married, when I do pre-marriage work with couples, I talk to them about, I say, now here's the thing, when you get married, you're going to probably only have two or three fights your entire married life. Two or three fights. The problem is you will have them thousands of times because we fight over the same thing over. If you could go back and videotape certain fights and just lay that video over another video, you would laugh at how you have the same crazy, silly fights. And so I want to challenge you. Figure out what are those areas that we quarrel, that we debate. If you're married and there's ongoing battles, what are your two or three biggest battle points? Points of quarreling, disagreement. And if you can remove one of those with humility and grace and say, I'm not going to fight about that anymore, you'll cut maybe a third of your battles out. You might save yourself hundreds of fights by removing one particular area. Don't be quarrelsome in your marriage. Deal with the tough things, have the conversation, pray through things, but don't delight in quarrelsomeness. Don't push that forward, but seek peace in your marriage. In verse 14, we read this. Houses and wealth are inherited from parents, but a prudent wife is from the Lord. Your parents can pass things on to you, but a godly, wise spouse is a gift from God. I want to challenge you, if you're a parent or a grandparent, pray for the spouse of your child or your grandchild. I've got a little grandson. My son, Zach, and his wife, Christine, and actually Thomas, who's filming us, that's Thomas's sister. So this will be your nephew. But this little guy, I have spent time already praying for his wife. He's still in his mother's womb. Why am I praying for his wife? Because it's so important. It's a gift from the Lord. I've got another granddaughter, Piper Joy, my son, Nate, and his wife, Bryn's daughter. And their son, Cohen. I'm praying for Piper Joy's husband. And I'm praying for Cohen's wife. I'm praying already, Lord, raise up the right person who is godly and prudent and loves you. Because who you marry matters. In our world, it's so confused. Pray, if you have a son or a grandson, pray for a godly wife. If you have a granddaughter or a daughter, pray for a godly husband. And start praying now. It will make a difference. I thank the Lord for all three of the women that are married to my three sons. But can I tell you something? Sherry and I were praying for their spouses. We were praying for our sons' wives while our sons were still in Sherry's womb and all through their upbringing. God hears those prayers. Verse 18 says this, "Discipline your children, for in that there is hope. Do not be a willing party to their death." What? Proverbs says, don't be a willing party to the death of your child. If you don't discipline your child, if you don't have boundaries, and you can figure out what discipline looks like, but man, discipline needs to be clear, communicated, and strong enough to get their attention and cost something. And man, when you discipline your kids and you love them enough to do that, you give them life. If you refuse to discipline your children, Proverbs says you become a willing party to their death. You kill their future, you kill their hope because you don't love them enough to discipline them. So prayerfully, wisely, biblically, discipline your kids. And then finally in verse 26, "Whoever robs their father and drives out their mother is a child who brings shame and disgrace." Treat your parents well. as long as they have life, as long as they have strength. Treat them well. Honor them. Give them a call today. Drop them a note. Shoot them a text. Say a prayer for them and let them know you're praying for them. But honoring parents is one of the Ten Commandments. Honor your parents and God will bless you in that process. Will you pray with me? Lord, thank you for the gift of family. Even though family seems to be falling on hard times globally and in our culture, even though there's challenges in families, Lord, what a gift it is. We pray that we would honor you by the way we love spouses, by the way we love children and grandchildren, by the way we love and honor parents. I pray you will build strong families in the lives of each person listening to these words. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, be sure to register for worship services this weekend. It's going to be a great, great weekend of worship. I invite you to register. If you're online, we'll see you online. And if you're still at home and you've been vaccinated or you're immunized and you feel like you're able to come back and join us, come join us in the parking lot for outdoors, in the courtyard, in the family worship venue, in the worship center, in the immunized section or non-immunized section, social distancing, non-social distancing. We got options for everybody. So when you're ready, come back and join us. God bless you. And we'll see you this Sunday, either on campus or online. Have a great day.